Hello everyone, welcome to Watches Consulting. In this video, we will be discussing JasperReports server and Jaspersoft Studio installation. And also we will see how a sample report can be developed using the studio and how it can be exported into Jaspersoft server. First, we will see the JasperReports server installation. For this, go to community.jaspersoft.com. Click on download now. Here we have two options available. Go with community edition and click on download now. Under the community editions, select the JasperReports server and click on download. Click on continue to download. This will take you to Jaspersoft community login or register page. Here I have already registered into community page, so directly logging into the community. In this page, select the version 8.0.0. My OS is 64-bit, so selecting 64-bit.exe file into my machine. You will see the software started getting downloaded. This will take some time to download and it is depends on your internet speed. The file is downloaded with the size of 364 MB and it is ready to install now. Open the file. Click on next. Do you accept this license? Select yes. Click on next. Select the install option as install all and click on next. I'm not changing the installation folder path and keeping as is. Click on next. If you want to use Chrome, select yes and click on next. Click on next. Click on next. And again click on next. Now you can see it started unpacking the executing files and this will take some time to install the software. Here during the installation process, few sample databases like Sugar CRM, FoodMart also getting created. Here using any of the database, we can establish a connection and can develop a report. I will show you how to do that using Jaspersoft Studio. Now you will see the option as start JasperReports server and open browser to login page. Please select the checkbox and click on finish. This will open this Jasper server in a separate browser. Login into server using user ID as JasperAdmin and password as JasperAdmin and click on login. Once you log into page, you will see the folder structure in left side of the panel. Here go to reports, go to interactive. Right now in this folder, these are the out of the box reports available. Next I will show you how to install a Jaspersoft Studio. Again go to community.jaspersoft.com and click on download now. Select the community edition and click on download now. So under the community editions, select the Jaspersoft Studio and click on download. Click on continue to download. Go to Jaspersoft Studio version 6.2.0.0. Click on 64-bit.exe file. And this will take some time to download the software. The software is downloaded and it is ready to install. The installation steps are simple and straightforward. And open the studio once the installation is completed. Now we have the studio and server is available to develop a report and deploy into server. First, we will create a custom report folder under reports folder. Next, open the studio. Now I have already the server and foodmod database configured in the studio. To create a new report, go to file, click on map, click on Jasper report, select the blank info template, click on next, change the file name to sample weekly report. Click on next. Select the data reference foodmod DB. Select the public. Select the table. Prepare a select query for the output table and take all the fields into the report. Next, select all fields the right side of the panel. Click on next. I'm not selecting fields to group by. Click on next. Click on finish. Since it is a sample report, I'm removing the page header, column footer, page footer, and summary. Now I am using only the title, column header, legal box. Under the outline, go to fields. Select all the fields into detail band. The title band, select the text field and add the report name as sample grid report. You can finish. Increase the font size of the columns. Save the report and export into server and select the custom folder which we created earlier. Next, here we have the option to select the data source. Select the first option, data source from the poster. Go to data resources, select the foodmod DB, click on finish. Now the report is successfully exported into server. Now you can log in into server and verify the report. Go to reports, go to custom folder and run the sample report. That's all in this session. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe the channel for more videos.